have an issue. The power button on my PC is broken. Unlike how I imagine most people would react, I got excited by this news. My first instinct was that I am gonna put a microcontroller in this case, bypass the power button so I can control the PC power from my phone, maybe connect it to the internal COM port so I can monitor other stats like memory and CPU usage, even connect it to the case lights so I can control their brightness, maybe even throw in a couple external buttons to work as macro keys. But before I over-engineer this problem to the moon and back, we really should check if we can't just replace the power button, because this is most certainly a mechanical issue with the tactile button itself. I tried looking for this particular switch but couldn't find an exact replacement that I could source in a reasonable time frame. And I don't want to botch just a regular button in its place. So for now, it seems that we are proceeding with the over-engineered solution. Now, as much as I would like to use this amazing ESP32 dev board, it would be a total overkill for this relatively simple project. All we really need is Wi-Fi and a couple of GPIO pins. This VMOS D1 mini board that is based around the ESP8266 should be more than enough for our purposes. Now, it's time for some research. First of all, we need to figure out how the original power button works. It is connected to the motherboard here via this 2-pin header. My intuition is that one of these pins is connected directly to ground. If we check with a multimeter in continuity mode against one of the screws on the motherboard, the right pin indeed seems to be connected to the ground plane. That means to turn on the computer, all our microcontroller would have to do is pull the left pin to ground momentarily. Next, we need to figure out how we are going to send the macro commands to the PC. Some of the Arduino boards like the Leonardo have a feature where they can act as a USB input device, but the ESP doesn't have any such functionality natively. I know that there is a project out there called ESP-USB that allows us to bit bang a software USB protocol, but that works directly on top of ESP-SDK and is not compatible with the Arduino library. So the only other option left for us is to send the commands via serial and convert them to key presses on the PC side. A few programs already exist that do this, but I decided to write my own because I also wanted to send back some system stats. I decided to write this code in C++ instead of Python to keep it small and lightweight on the system resources, since it would likely be running all the time in the background. Next up, on the ESP side, I have written a simple program that sends all the button presses to the serial and displays the received serial data in a web UI made with the ESP UI library. The same UI allows us to send the power on command, and I have also added a slider that will let me control the brightness of the case LEDs. Now, all that's left is to make a little keypad, wire everything up on a perf board, and shove everything inside the PC case. The source codes, the wiring diagrams, as well as the compiled binaries for all these programs will be available in the link in the description. A couple of things didn't go as planned. I wanted to connect the ESP to the COM1 port on my motherboard so I could guarantee the port number for the PC-sided software. But for some reason, I kept getting garbage values from that port. So I had to resort to using the USB 2.0 header instead. Now, through a couple dozen reboots, the port number has stayed the same, but I don't know if that will remain true indefinitely. Secondly, I wanted to put the ESP board inside the case to keep the wiring neat and tidy, But the metal case acts as a Faraday cage, and thus the ESP can't connect to the Wi-Fi. I had to stick it to the bottom of the case, which of course isn't ideal. If I had to do this again, I would have mounted the ESP inside the macro board case itself and brought out the required wires to it. Finally, some notes if you want to do this yourself. You should give the ESP a static IP address by going into your router settings. This way, you can place a shortcut to the web page on your home screen for easy access. The PC-sided software requires you to specify the COM port the ESP is connected to. The instructions on how to do that and how to make it start up automatically on boot up are in the GitHub in the description. You can forego the connection to the power button and the LED strip and instead use the extra GPIOs to create a bigger macro pad with up to 12 buttons. The instructions on how to do that are commented in the source code. Speaking of the macro pad, you can use it in any program or game of your choice, just like any other key on your keyboard. You can also massively expand the functionality by combining keys or having the keys perform different actions based on context with the help of a program called AutoHotkey. Again, the instructions are in the description. Overall, I am very happy with this over-engineered replacement for my power button. And if you enjoyed this video, hit that subscribe button and I'll see you guys in the next one.